Despite a barrage of attacks from the Duterte clan, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says his relationship with the vice president stays the same. He's also keeping Vice President Sara Duterte as his education secretary. Marcos also insisting the so-called Uniteam coalition is still standing.
It's exactly the same because she hasn't said anything of that nature. And wala naman siyang sinasabi na ganyang klase. So hindi naman nagbabago. If you remember, Uniteam is not just one party or two parties or three parties. It's the unification of all political, hopefully all the political forces in the Philippines to come together for the good of the country. And that is still there. It is still vibrant. It is still working.
Over the weekend, former President Rodrigo Duterte accused Marcos of being a drug addict and described First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos as power hungry. Marcos fired back, saying Duterte's alleged use of fentanyl is affecting his behavior. Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte also called on Marcos to resign. The Philippine Armed Forces sees no need for loyalty checks among its ranks despite the rift between President Marcos and his predecessor, Rodrigo Duterte. The military says it remains focused on ending the communist insurgency and defending the country's exclusive economic zone in the West Philippine Sea. AFP Chief Romeo Browner earlier called on government troops to remain nonpartisan and professional. Duterte had warned Marcos he may suffer the same fate as his father, who was ousted from the presidency by the civilian-backed military revolt in 1986.
Ang pinaka-keyword po dito is non-partisan po ang AFP. So we'll be continuing to have our focus in terms of yung ating mission po, no, to end our local terrorist insurgency problem and transition ultimately to territorial defense. Ang statement po ng Chief of Staff natin is there is not even a need for a loyalty check.
Philippine Senator Aimee Marcos says Davao City Mayor Baste Duterte apologized to her after he demanded the resignation of her brother. The senator said she called out the younger Duterte, but she says she understands the sentiment of the Davao City Mayor. Marcos also shared her thoughts on the tirade of former President Duterte against her brother.
Nakakaloka, yun lang masasabi ko doon, dahil nakakaloka. Ang lumapit sa akin ay si Mayor Baste Duterte. Nagsorry. Naintindihan ko naman kasi syempre sobrang emotional siya dahil isipin mo naman ikukulong yung tatay mo at yung ate mo. Talaga namang mag-re-revolution yung damdamin.
Turning now to the controversial push for charter change, President Marcos says he's consulting legal luminaries, including former Chief Justice and now Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin, as well as Presidential Legal Counsel Juan Ponce Enrile, on the issue surrounding the People's Initiative. Marcos says he is looking for a less complicated way to amend the charter since the ongoing effort for a People's Initiative is now tainted with politicking.
Naman ang habol ko talaga dyan are the economic provisions that I have been talking about this for many, many years already. So, napupunta sa ibang usapan at nagagamit na pampolitika itong issue na ito. So, I have asked the leaders of both houses and again, some of the best constitutional minds that we have in the Philippines to come up with a simpler solution that does not cause so much controversy. The best analysis and interpretation that we have is that the legislature is of a bicameral nature, and therefore that implies that they will vote separately. So how that will be done now is what we are trying to figure out. Well, how will it be done so that both houses' role in this bicameral system is preserved?
Meanwhile, the Philippine Senate adopts a resolution authorizing Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri to question the constitutionality of the People's Initiative. The resolution cited previous Supreme Court rulings saying the Initiative and Referendum Act meant to operationalize the People's Initiative is inadequate to cover the system of initiative on amendments to the Constitution. The resolution now allows Zubiri to file petitions in court against the ongoing effort. The resolution comes after the Philippine Senate opened its probe on the alleged involvement of the House Speaker and the use of cash aid in a signature drive for constitutional amendments. Sherry Ann Torres reports.
In the Philippine Senate's hearing into the People's Initiative, several witnesses from Bukidnon claimed to have been paid to promote charter change. They recounted the circumstances how they were recruited. At least one resource speaker says they were given cards that read Change Philippines and were told to present themselves as members of a non-government organization pushing for amendments to economic provisions in the Constitution.
Ang binigay sa amin, 1.5 po a day, tapos in advance po yung isang araw, bali 3,000 po yung natanggap namin.
May biglang dumating na nakalimang motor. Dala itong mga firm, sabi pwede magpapirma. Nabanggit din sila na about sa chatcha.
Witnesses from Quezon City say they signed the signature forms expecting aid in return, which they have yet to receive.
Basta pagkapirma po namin, may present number po, tapos ayuta daw po.
Utos daw po yun ng ni BBM.
Leaders of the People's Initiative for Reform and Modernization Action, or PIRMA, and Charter Change Advocate former Acobicol Congressman Alfredo Garbin both reject allegations cash and aid are being offered to entice people to support the initiative. Garbin also denies working with House Committee on Appropriations Chairman Elizalde Cole, who is the incumbent Acobicol Party List representative.
Nagtatrabaho po ako sa Acobicol Party List, which happens to be ang isang representante ay chairman ng Committee on Appropriation.
PIRMA National Lead Convener Noel Oñate says he only asked Cagayan de Oro City Congressman Rufus Rodriguez and Garbin on the number of voters in their district and nothing more. And when asked to explain a photo showing PIRMA officials taken with House Speaker Martin Romualdez and Congressman Cole last January 8, Oñate says he asked the speaker to help in the campaign, but his role is limited to advisory assistance.
Ako ang nagkumbida.
Paano ko magkukumbida? Di mo bahay?
Oo nga.
Mira naman.
Ang sabi ng staff, doon na lang gawin sa bahay ni speaker.
Initiative?
Initiate ng meeting. Pero sinabi po na doon na lang gawin sa townhouse ni Speaker.
Ay,
dapat
ganon.
Po sa bahay ko, pero sinabihan ako na doon na lang pumunta.
Oñate also rejects allegations Romualdez was behind the People's Initiative.
Sinabi mo, pirma ang nasa likuran nitong People's Initiative. Humingi kayo ng suporta galing kay Speaker Romualdez. Ibig sabihin, si Speaker Romualdez, isa na rin sa nasa likod.
Pumayag naman po si Speaker.
Pumayag
si Speaker.
Nasa likuran na rin siya.
Natulungan kami kasi siya ang CEO ng Congress. Yeah, he is helping us.
For De La Salle University College of Law Dean Chel Jokno, the public can sue public officials taking part in PI.
If the public funds were used for another purpose other than what they were intended for, yan po ay papasok sa malversation. Kung sa anti-graft naman, maaari din yan kasi meron na pagbabawal doon to induce another public officer to commit any violation of rules and regulations or the law. So yun po yung dalawa. Nandiyan din po yung RE 6713, Code of Conduct.
House leaders were notably absent from the hearing. The only congressman present during the inquiry is Rodante Marcoleta. The probe comes a day after the poll body indefinitely suspended all proceedings related to the People's Initiative. The Senate says it will continue its inquiry into the People's Initiative next month. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez clarifies his role on the ongoing People's Initiative effort. This after prime movers of the campaign admitted they coordinated with the House Speaker for the Charter Change signature drive. But Romualdez asserts he was merely an advisor and not the leader of the scheme. Other House leaders coming to the defense of the Speaker.
So, sa akin, It shouldn't be taken with malice. It had nothing to do with ill intent.
Yun ang magandang balita at siyempre naman.
Romualdez also appealing to his cousin, Senator Amy Marcos, to stop her tirades. But this only earned the ire of the senator.
Ceasefire daw. Wala daw bastusan. Siya naman ang nagsabi, walang pake ang Senado. Ayan. Siya nag-umpisa. Nung inugali ko, yung ugali niya, umiiyak siya.
Over now to the president's state visit in Vietnam. President Marcos also saw the bilateral code of conduct in the South China Sea between the Philippines and Vietnam may soon be finalized. During his trip, Marcos forged several deals with Vietnamese officials, including an agreement on incident prevention and management in the South China Sea.
Kung hindi natin matapos ang code of conduct with ASEAN and China, ay sabi ko, hindi gawin natin bilateral lang muna ng members of ASEAN para naman hindi na natin kailangan alalahanin na magkakaproblema tayo sa Vietnam, magkakaproblema tayo sa Brunei, magkakaproblema tayo sa Malaysia, etc., etc. So we don't have any confrontations with Vietnam, as a matter of fact. Despite the fact that we have conflicts in territorial waters, about territorial waters, but it has never gone beyond any diplomatic contacts. Hindi na pupunta sa gulo.
Discussions on a code of conduct between China and ASEAN members have been ongoing for over a decade, but the parties have failed to hurdle several deadlocks, including Beijing's push to ban joint military trainings in the waterway, which it illegally claims. The Philippine Armed Forces unfazed by Chinese vessels swarming the West Philippine Sea. Over 200 Chinese ships have been spotted around the mischief reef near Ayungin Shoal. But Commodore Roy Vincent Trinidad, Navy spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, says their presence is not alarming. He adds the AFP has deployed enough Philippine ships to secure the country's territory.
At any one time, it's difficult to give you the exact number, considering that ang mga barko naman doon, they constant motion. But if in mischief reef, which is an enclosed safe harbor, at any one time, somewhere from 15 to 25 warships, we have more maritime militia. As of the last count, broad picture, I would say around 200. And for the Chinese Coast Guard, I think another 10 to 15.